I'm making the frames to go around the halves of the combustion chamber out of 60-66 angle. It's quite heavy, but not overly so. I've got to cut some short legs to go on those sides, and then a front plate and a back plate that will drill and tap into these, and a hinge on a slot so that I can adjust the pinch, and a latch and a slot so I can adjust the grab. Then be a piece of fire glass involved and some fire rope. And that'll be about it. This is the batch box with its frame roughly dangled in place and tacked. It's looking all right. There's a few glaring problems with the concrete, but I have no choice but to ignore them and carry on. I set the core in one in a slightly different place to the other, so I've got a mismatched chimney, which is a real pain, and there's not much I can do about it. So we're just going to have an offset chimney. It's only the first bit of the riser, so it might not make too much difference. And this lump of missing concrete down there. The clay balls, for anybody that is following me down this, are a complete waste of time as far as I can tell. Unless you can trap a cavity full of clay balls and pump in very runny concrete, all they do is float. Oh, I'm really pissed off about it. I've tried to fill in the gap with fire cement, and I think I probably will continue to do that, but you know, that's quite a lot of fire cement. So it might just have to get squished in around the edges where the angle is, just to hold the concrete in place. I don't know, caulking gun fire cement or something. I'm really pissed off. I've put so much work into it. So anyway, the concrete's in two halves, the steel frame is in two halves. The steel frame is connected with this door frame at the front and two straps at the back. And this hopefully will allow me to assemble it in two halves in situ, which means I don't have to manipulate that huge block of concrete and steel. Obviously, there's going to be another panel on here with some glass in it, and the vents for the primary and secondary air. I've got to fill in these holes and pretty all this up. But it's nice to see it like that. So today I made the secondary air duct, which went quite nicely. I've countersunk these holes, so that's flush. I made these quite nice adjustable door hinge hangers, which one thing I remember from previous furnace projects is having both sides of the door adjustable is really helpful for getting a good seal. So if it's a little bit loose, you can just slide it back and forth. I haven't quite decided what I'm going to do on the other side, but I've just found somewhere locally that sells glass and rope and glue. So I'm off there to buy that now. Whee! Whilst the fire's been burning, I've been working on the door. It looks a little overcomplicated, I know, but that is my nature. But it does work quite nicely. So the hinges here are adjustable that way to adjust the pinch on the tight side, and then the latch, so this noggin hooks under this bit of bolt here, thus, and then it's held shut by that kind of gate latch. And again, all these are adjustable because I just know from previous things, both sides adjustable, you can get each side perfectly tensioned to squeeze the fire rope. The only thing I haven't achieved is making it stay up so it does that, which is a bit annoying, but you know what, I think that'll do. The inside of the door looks quite smart. There is a channel that rope is sat in, defined by an inner and an outer plate with a gap in the middle, hence the two sets of screws. Nice, it is very nice. Obviously the bolts will be replaced with something prettier, and I'm tempted to polish the front, because you know how they go for shiny things.